The excitement is building, there's electricity in the air. But there's no surprise in that, it's race day.
Monaco can hand out unpredictable results, just like in 1982, when four race leaders hit trouble. Ricardo Patrese eventually claimed the win after managing to restart his stalled car by himself with a downhill bump start. And the sky is looking grey and cloudy today. An effective tyre strategy could prove very valuable as the race plays out.
The streets of Monte Carlo are ready as the drivers prepare for the 78 laps of the Monaco Grand Prix. And plenty of people watching on will be keen to follow Fernando Alonso's progress.
They're in second place on the grid, but that could so easily change in the first few seconds after lights out.
Right, let's get to it then. It's time for one of the most exciting races in the world. This is the Monaco Grand Prix. And it's lights out, and away we go.
Use energy.
Yeah, okay.
No saving required.
Okay.
We've got a yellow flag here.
Car in the wall. Be very careful. Yeah, take it easy.
Yep.
Thank you. Let's take a closer look. Let's have a look at the action. It's all at the final corner. The opportunity begging to be taken. And Lando says, well, thank you very much.
Bit less curb.
Yeah.
Do everything you can.
Confirm.
Now this was Valtteri Bottas. It's there for the taking. And up into 14th they go.
A lot, a bit less curb.
Yeah.
Go get it. Maybe just take it easy on the straight.
Yeah.
Okay, so keep going. You can stop, lift and coast. You got loads of energy when you need it.
Copy.
And a bit of charging.
Copy.
DRS is in there. P15. You've got Bottas ahead. So car behind is Sargent.